Good morning all. We are getting into the module 2 of IoT and wireless sensor networks. The module 2 actually deals with the protocols that are useful in the internet. The protocols that are useful or widely used are mainly TCP/IP, then RPL, then 6LoWPAN, and all these protocols are useful for transmitting the data from the lower level, that is from the sensor, to the upper level, that is the internet. And whenever we are speaking about the protocols, each and every protocol will be having some header words. The header words are placed as per the actions required at the succeeding stages. Say for example, whenever your data is coming into the system, then there should be some information about the data. What is the type of data and what is the size of the data and what are the specifications of the data. So all these things should be available so that the system can easily process the data. And these informations are provided as header files or header data. And each header word at a layer consists of one or more header fields. So each and every header word will be consisting of header fields. And each and every field specify the actions, right? What all the actions we can do. Say for example, from which address it is stored or which address it is to be transmitted and what type of security is used. And all those things will be available in each and every fields. And the header field specify a set of parameters encoded in a header. And the parameters and their encoding as per the protocol used at that particular layer. For example, the fourth header field, right, for 32-bit source IP address in network layer using IP. Say for example, I think these are all simple English. I think say for example, one example they have given it, so IP address. In the IP address, the fourth header field gives the source IP address from where the data is originated. And the next one will be giving where the what is the destination of the IP data, right? So these are the informations that are available in the header fields. And the protocol header, an example for this header field. And the header field means a bit in a header word placed at appropriate bit place. For example, from 0 to 31, right? Normally a header word will be having 32 bits. So the first word field is from B16 to B31 for any IP packet, right? So that denotes what is the length of the packet, right? What is the amount of data that is being transmitted in bytes. And B14 and 15 is the service type, right? Service type is actually something like assigning the priority and all those things. So the service type will be given there, whether the data can be fragmented or not. That is again another information. And the B0 to B3, that indicates the IP version. So totally we are using IPv4 and IPv6. Two versions are actually available now. So it will be coded as 0100 for IPv4 and 0101 for IPv6. And the IP header field consists of parameters and their encodings, which are as per the IP protocol. Of course, we have seen that. And an internet layer protocol at a source or destination in TCP/IP suite of protocols. So a TCP/IP is a combination or suite of protocols which are useful for transmitting the data throughout the internet. The TCP header, right? So we have seen some examples in the IP side. Now we are getting into the TCP header. The TCP header field consists of parameters and their encodings which are as per the TCP protocol. Of course, we know that. And TCP at a source or destination transport layer. So this is actually available in the transport layer of this ISO OSI model. And the TCP stream is actually a data stack, right? It's a sequence of bytes or words, whatever it is, from source end to the destination end of the transport layer, right? Because TCP is laying in the transport layer. And the data need to be transmitted from a source end transport layer to the destination end transport layer. And whenever the data is received on the receiver side, there should be an acknowledgement should be produced. An acknowledgement TCP stream data stack from destination to the source. That is the back reverse. And the port is an interface, right? Or it is a software to the network which uses a protocol for sending a data stack. Say for example, we have TCP. But the data transmitted may be from different applications. Say for example, it can be from a mail, right? We are sending some mails and all those things. It can be in normal web browsing, right? You are searching something for in google.co.in or something like that. Or you will be having some bulk data transfer using this FTP, right? So FTP stands for file transfer protocol, simple mail transfer protocol, SMTP or HTTP, hypertext, right? So all these things are normally used as different applications. Right? So these applications are generally known as ports. The port receives a data stack at the input at the receiver and application layer, and each port at application layer uses distinct protocol, right? The port number. Each and every port is assigned with a unique number. For example, HTTP protocol is having a number of 80. HTTPS, which is actually a secured HTTP protocol, is having a port number of 443. There are some examples. Ports in TCP/IP suite. Right. So a port uses a protocol for sending and receiving the messages. So consisting of numbers of application layer protocols, for example, that's what I said, HTTP is a separate application, HTTPS is another application, FTP, Telnet, and all those things. Supposing if I am getting a data from a HTTP server, the data should be given to the destination of, again, HTTP, right? Supposing you are using a mail browser, I mean, you are using a mail and you are having a browser, the browser data is distinct from the mail, right? So the corresponding application should be given the corresponding data, right? So that is actually the application of this TCP and IP ports. A TCP/IP message must be sent from the right port at transmission end and to the right port at the receiver end. Say, for example, we cannot open a mail in a web browser, right? Of course, we have an application for that, but the HTTP can equally handle this SMTP also, right? Supposing if you are going to use an SMTP, then that should be used for accessing the mails. We cannot use HTTP for that, right? Similarly, for FTP data, we cannot use it with HTTP. And what is a packet? A packet is a fixed maximum size of bytes which communicates from internet layer to the router and from one router to another router till the packet reaches the physical data link or physical or data link layer at the receiver end, right? So here actually each and every packet will be a collection of bits or a collection of data that can be packed together to form a packet, and this is transmitted from the internet layer to so many routers. And there are so many routing algorithms are also available, and when the data passes through these routers, at one point of time it reaches the destination, and at the destination or at the receiver end, the data is again getting processed, and the packet routes through a path decided by each router. So the routing algorithm, there are plenty of routing algorithms are there, and the router will take care of how to route the data safely and in a shortest path. And there is a socket. Normally we call it as a socket programming. Whenever we come to the internet programming, we call it as a socket programming. It's an interface to the network that sends a data stack at the application output using a port protocol to the lower layer and using an IP address to the network for another socket at the receiver end. Right. So normally this TCP/IP protocol programming is actually called as socket programming. A socket is assigned a port number and IP address. So a socket is a combination of a port number and the corresponding IP address. A network interface, a system software component or hardware for facilitating communication between two protocol layers or computers. Right. So that is actually the network interface. It is a hardware interface that facilitates the connection between two protocol layers or two computers. The interface software component provides standard functions. So it is not only the hardware, it's a part of software for transmitting the data from one system to some other system. The source and network layer. So the source and network layer communicate with the IoT MTM. So this is actually the protocol that is useful in our IoT, and the IoT applications and services layer is available there. And this is actually the source of your data. And using this TCP/IP suite of application protocols, the data is getting transmitted and connect through a set of IP routers. So it is the data is routed through so many IP routers, and then the data will be received at the destination IP address. This is actually the overall diagram of the total system.